ICU patients in Melbourne's West are being sent home after treatment instead of being transferred to a general ward for recovery. It's happened due to a serious shortage of beds. State political reporter Mark Santomartino.
When no beds are available, Dr. Craig French has been forced to keep patients in his ICU.
Patients can even wait a number of days before they're discharged from intensive care, and by that time they're actually ready to go home.
That's happened four times in recent weeks at Western Health, thanks to a rise in COVID-infected patients and the number of healthcare workers off sick, which prompted a warning of six-hour waits last night at the Royal Children's.
It's definitely daunting to think about what is ahead, but at the same time, having this experience as a student nurse has definitely prepared me for that.
1,000 student midwives and nurses will soon start filtering into 30 hospitals, including Western Health. And after promising new or upgraded hospitals in Melton, Mildura, Warragul and Wodonga, St Arnold and Sandringham, Matthew Guy added a $340 million Rosebud rebuild to his list.
It's been nearly 30 years since any money's been put into this hospital.
To realise its vision for Rosebud, the coalition will both need to be elected this November and go cap in hand to Anthony Albanese for at least an additional $100 million.
It doesn't meet Australian standards. The operating theatres have closed down.
This is not going to be fixed overnight. It is an unprecedented demand, unprecedented pressures on our health services.
No one's being discharged early or anything like that. But it is a reflection of the overall strain that the health service is under at this time.
Mark Santomartino, Nine News.